Summer is here, and that means, like you, we're trying to figure out ways to stay cool without breaking the bank. Now, our main house has central heating and air, so that's fine. But over here in the office, all we have is this eyesore of a window AC. Now, whenever I talk about cooling on this channel, you guys always leave hundreds of comments that I gotta check out Mr. Cool. So we reached out. Big thanks to Mr. Cool for sponsoring this video and sending us a unit to install, but that still leaves the hard work of doing the DIY installation. As you can tell, this system is going to be much more complicated than just a window AC. So is it worth it? What are the pros and cons? Let's figure this out and figure out what use cases it would make sense for you. I'm Ricky, and this is 2-Bit Da Vinci. All right, so first of all, if you're looking for the easiest DIY installation, a window AC can't be beat. This is gonna be more complicated. For example, you have an indoor and outdoor unit. That's part of what makes it special. This is the outdoor air handler, and this has to have a footing, for example. So we had to prep the ground a little bit. We put some casings and poured concrete for the footing, and that was all part of the prep work for this. Now, it's not wired in yet. We'll do that here in a second. But obviously, you can imagine this is what makes these things really efficient, the fact that you have a big, massive heat exchanger on the outside and one for the inside. But it does mean more insulation work, so let's get started. So, being a DIY system, here's the template for the inside unit. And you can see here this little circle. You're supposed to drill that hole on the inside all the way to the outside. And they give you good covers and plates to be able to mount on the wall to run it straight down. So if we didn't have this window here, for example, and we mounted it there, we could run it straight down. But because this window's here, it'll be just too complicated. And we want the air handler behind us, and this stairway is kind of in the way too. So what we're gonna do is make it more complicated for ourselves and do it on the inside of the wall between the 2x4s. But you could make this way easier on yourself if you just run the line set all the way to the outside. And that's kind of the preferred and recommended way. Now, when they say DIY, what they really mean is you can do it yourself without a HVAC contractor because the line set is already charged with the refrigerant. So you just open a couple of valves and the system charges and you're good to go, which is amazing. But there's still electrical to be done. So this has to be hardwired into a circuit on your service panel. And that requires an electrician. Unless you know what you're doing, and we're not gonna recommend that, that's up to you. But hiring an electrician to run that shouldn't cost you all that much money. But you do need to hire someone to take care of the electrical component. This outdoor unit is hardwired into the service panel. And then from here, the line set actually has power that runs to the indoor unit. So this is really the heart of where it gets tied in to your service panel. All right, now here's the template. You can hold it up and figure out where you want to install it. Make sure to check the manual for installation guides. Like for example, you want 5 or 6 inches above the unit because that's where the inlet is for the air to come in. You want to be off the walls and other stuff, but we're going to put it about here. Now all we gotta do is poke some holes to mount the bracket and cut out this where the line set is gonna go in the wall.
Cool.
So this is the line set, 25 feet worth. So it's gotta come down and around. So we're gonna feed it in, under the house, and up the wall. All right, frame, you ready? All right, now this is DIY, but yourself is an exaggeration, at least for me. I've got my team helping me. I got a couple of guys. So yeah, there's quite a bit to this. So definitely call for help, call a neighbor, family friend, somebody to help you. You think you can do it 2 people?
Yeah.
Yeah, 2 people. 2 people would do it. All right. This is not heavy, by the way. Really light. That's nice. And we gotta feed this down that wall. All right.
That's in.
We're in. Okay, so that looks cool. Now, we gotta feed this through. There's the drain line, this is the line set, and we gotta feed the new line set up, right?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So one of us needs to be in this air-conditioned room really the harder job, like to pull it up, and one of us needs to be under the house in the mud. That's really, I mean, the easier job. So I'll let the guys take that one. I'll pull from up here. You're welcome, by the way.
Oh, thanks.
I'm just kidding. All right, here goes the power. That was my idea, by the way. This is actually really important. We want to make sure there's no leaks anywhere, any drips. That would not be good. So we'll double check all that stuff before we connect it and put the wall back up. All right, this is actually going pretty smooth. It is 2:45. We're making pretty good progress. I'm impressed. I didn't think we'd be this far along. Next up, we're outside. We're gonna drill a pilot hole to cut the line set that we're gonna pass the power to the indoor unit, line set, and drain all out to here. So let's go. That was too easy. Man, I'm strong. Ugh. All right, now in terms of electrical, here we have the new 20 amp line coming from our service panel that's getting wired in right now. And then from this unit, this black line that goes up into the indoor air handler gets plugged in as well. So this is kind of the central part where all the electrical comes together. All we really have left to do, bend the lines, wire everything together, put that cap on, make sure everything's nice and sealed up, and we're almost done. All right, it's now 4 o'clock. And we're pretty much done. All we have to do is, once we have everything pressure checked, we'll screw it down into this footing. But what makes this DIY and what makes Mr. Cool so cool is all the refrigerant is actually right here. To release it, now that we have everything connected, right, this goes to the indoor unit, this is electrical from the service panel, and here are the supply and return lines for the refrigerant. Now that everything is tighten down, we'll do a little pressure check with some soapy water. I'll just go ahead and take off both of these caps. These caps just hide the valve inside to now release the refrigerant. Gotta hope it didn't screw this up. All right, we'll find out. Here we go. Ooh, you hear that? You can hear that whooshing sound. We turn it counterclockwise until it stops all the way. All right, we'll leave this for a little while, but I think it's time to run the electrical and give it a power run. So we had every tool to do this job, which is amazing, but it didn't come with AAA batteries. You'll need two of those. Here we go, moment of truth. It's alive! Yes, we did it. All right, now for the mode. Let's see. We'll go to cool. Ooh. And then let's set the temperature down a bit. Ooh, come with me outside. Let's see if the compressor's kicked on. It's working. I can feel hot air coming out of here and I can hear the compressor. Let's do a little audio check. That is really, really quiet. And I can hear the compressor is running. I can feel the hot air coming out, but it's all really nice and quiet. Let's go back inside. Holy moly, I can feel the air all the way out here. Here's the crazy part. No vibration. All I hear, this is on turbo mode, right? Here's the level of ambient noise in here. That is really awesome. Way quieter. This is heating and cooling. So in the winter time, all you do is just turn on heat and the pump reverses and the hot air comes out here and the cold air goes out there. So this doesn't just replace that. It replaces the resistive heaters that we had sitting around here. We don't need those anymore either. We have all of that and it's way more efficient. This has a SEER, a seasonal energy efficiency rating, S-E-E-R, of 22. And this is like 14. Those are the two things I was looking for. Because if we're gonna be in here working in the summertime, I could work with that. I can hear you guys just fine. Juan, say something.
Hello, how you doing?
Normal voice, that is cool. All right, now we'll try this one, okay? So we'll go to cool mode. It's not bad, it's not bad. These are fine. Like if you wanna get a window AC, this is way easier, obviously, but I mean, compared to this, it's just It's one of those things that just you won't notice until you have it running for any period of time. So let's really quickly nerd out a little bit about why these are so freaking efficient. One, they're ductless, right? There's no ducting that's getting hot or cold that has to be transferred around. The piping comes in right here, the evaporator is right there, the cooler, the condenser, and the cool or the hot air is right where you need it. So there's no ducts. Two, because you have an indoor and outdoor unit, you saw that outdoor unit, it is a massive heat exchanger. There's a ton of room to pull in air over the coils to move that heat out or to move that heat in, depending on which mode you're running it in. So it's just way more efficient because less compared to this, where this is your inlet, that's where the air comes in. And on the outside, similarly, there's just less air transfer. So as a result, even if this system can crank up and have higher levels of cooling, it might not actually make it to you because it can't move that heat as efficiently. This has a massive inlet on the top that spans that entire length. And on the outside unit, it's even bigger. So as a result, more efficient heat transfer through the heat exchangers, no ducting, and just overall, you know, high-end inverters and compressors. You just heard how quiet that was out there. Just that next level of tech. I think we're ready, boys, to just let this run for a couple of hours, make sure there's nothing going wrong, and then we'll put that drywall back up. But first, let's put the AC back on. It's hot in here. All right, I think we're ready to take this crap out. All right, now it's not gonna be easy because of how we put it in. All right, after some drywall work and some paint, we're back in business. Now, is this truly a DIY system? Yeah, it is. Now, I'm not gonna lie, when I first saw everything in the line set and I had to bend it around corners, I was kind of scared and intimidated, but luckily I had a friend who'd kind of done this kind of stuff before who really made it comfortable and easy for me. First advice for you would be call your handiest friend, buy some pizza, buy some beer, have them help you. And honestly, if you do it the way they recommend, which is straight out the wall and down the side of your house, you can probably have this done in a couple of hours. The way we did with all the drywall work and stuff, it took about 2 days for all the drywall repairs and painting and drying and all that kind of stuff. But pretty amazing that we did this ourselves. Now let's talk a little bit about the day-to-day operations. We've had this now for 2 weeks and how we like it. Starting with how cool the smart application is. Hey, turn on the office AC. So Siri shortcuts work. The first feedback was installing the little Wi-Fi adapter, the part that makes this smart, was one of the easiest we've ever done on any of these Wi-Fi IoT kind of products. It was really easy. Okay, that's good. And it makes it a breeze. You can set it to your desired temperature. We have it around 77 and does a really good job of hitting that. The fan speed, heating or cooling. So I can have another one say, turn on the office heater, and it'll turn on the heater in the summertime. Because remember, these are reversible. There's a heater and an AC. That's the coolest part about it. I'm in my smart home panel app and it's showing you the energy usage here. It's about 500 watts, which means that the compressor is probably turned on. But to really make it push harder, we'll have to turn the setting. Let's turn that down to like 69 degrees. No reason for that number, just a random number. And we'll turn the fan speed to turbo. So the app does everything. There's also the remote control, which works really well as well, whatever you prefer. But now this is running. One thing we wanted to do, because this is a single zone air conditioner, it does such a killer job of cooling this room that we actually installed a vent right up here. And this is a booster vent that just pushes air from this room into our recording studio. So now when I'm recording a video, this thing is so quiet, I can have it run, listen. And this is on turbo. No vibrations, nothing's rattling. And we can turn on this booster fan and keep air flowing into the studio to keep me cool and not sweaty while I'm recording videos. That might be the biggest game changer because before this, that studio wasn't really habitable for more than about 30 minutes. But now I can just plop down there, have my little quiet space to get work done, which is amazing. And of course you can get the dual zone or three zone systems, but this is the coolest one because it was a 110 install. Really simple, and this is such a cool little device that I want to get one for our main house. Our master bedroom is the only room upstairs, and it is like 8 degrees warmer than the rest of the house. If I got one of these mounted up there, I could not even run the whole house AC, just run one of these on 700 watts. That's all this is using right now, 642. and cool my house. Now, to put this into perspective, my old window AC that we used to have when we started this video was pulling 1200 watts and it would never cool this room. This room would never be cold enough to the temperature setting. So we would just set it to like 70 degrees. It would never turn off and it would just keep moving air around. We had air gaps and stuff, and the fan, right? The heat exchangers were just so small that it just couldn't move that much heat, even though there was a compressor probably using as much energy as this system. But that system has a massive radiator for heat exchange. And this also is much bigger. So this uses half the power and does a way better job. So all in, these are fantastic. I get why all of you told me to get one. And in fact, I'm gonna turn around and buy a second one for the main house. All right, so stay cool this summer with Mr. Cool. Amazing little product, truly great customer service, great product, great company. Definitely check it out. Links in the description. All right, and if you thought that was cool, you gotta watch this video next.